So is the slide visible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
The next topic after the topic of biconnectivity and biconnected components of a graph that we've seen in the previous lecture is, as per our syllabus, it is Euler circuit. So Euler is a mathematician. By his name only, the particular concept is discussed in order to derive a circuit from a, or what is that, a path from a given graph. So I already told you that a graph is representing a geographical relationship. So that means this node may correspond to one city, this node may correspond to one city, or this node may correspond to one place, this node may correspond to one place, or this node may correspond to one country, this node may correspond to one country. So likewise, this is one airport, this is another airport, this is one bus station, this is another bus station. Likewise, we can take this number is not the number along the edge. This number is the number for the node, not the node. In case if you find any value here, that is between the node, there is a connection, and if you find any number in this connection, that means the effort or the cost or the distance or maybe some kind of value has to be associated with the node or the one who is passing from this node to that node. So that is the one, and it is popularly called by the name weight or cost. But here it is not, we are not going to talk about the cost or weight. But so this number 18763, this represents a node number. Let me come to your point. What is Euler circuit? It is an Euler path. So it is a circuit or a path discovered by a mathematician named Euler, whose idea is to, you have to start from one vertex. You have to start from one vertex, and you have to end in the same vertex. You have to end in the same vertex. So while starting from the vertex, you need to visit every edge. You need to visit every edge such that each edge should be visited only once. In doing so, you derive a path. You derive a path, and that path is called Eulerian path. Remember, students, here visits every edge exactly once. This is little contradictory when compared with the traversal operation. When you discuss about the traversal operation, it is the task of visiting the node. But here it is the task of traveling on the edge. So once you choose a particular path from one node to another node, then the same path should not be used again. So that's what Euler is going to tell about. So for this graph, what might be the Eulerian path or what might be the Euler path? In case if I choose one as the starting node, so as per the Euler circuit, where I have to end? I have to end at the one. What is another condition given by Euler? That is, each edge should be visited once. That is, every edge should be visited once. So my path may be, I can travel from 1 to 8 this way, 1 to 8, then 8 to 3, then 3 to 6, then 6 to 8, then 8 to 7, then 7 to 2, then 2 to 4, then 4 to 5, then 5 to 6, then 6 to 2, then 2 to 3, then 3 to 1. Do you think that whether during this travel from the node where I have started to the node where I have started to end the node? So both are same nodes. That is, 1 I have started and I have ended with 1. So along this travel, you cannot see that I have used one edge more than once. If you say that 1 to 8, 8 to 3, 3 to 6, 6 to 8, 8 to 7. So no more edges repeating, one more time. So that path, that kind of path is called as Euler path. You wonder now that what is the use of this? Why he need to find this path from the given graph? Is there any real world problem associated with this kind of problem? Yes, of course. When you take the history before understanding what is Euler circuit is, you should always remember a kind of game that you wish to play during your childhood days. Maybe I played during my childhood days. That is, when a graph is, when a diagram is given like this, so what you have to do is, you have to start from a line, but without taking the hand from the drawing, I have to draw a line and I should make a condition that I should not overwrite a particular arc. That means I should not go one more time in the particular arc. But at the same time, I should visit the, that is my travel should end at the place where I have started. So that is the challenging problem one has to address. That is it possible to draw this figure? I have to draw this figure without lifting your pencil from the paper and without tracing any of the lines more than once. Guys, I think you understood now what is I am going to convey. So what is the history behind it? What is the history behind it? So during the year 1707 to 1783, this mathematician lived during the 18th century, and his name is Leonhard Euler, and he is a Swiss mathematician. And what is the problem he faced is, see, if you look at it, so that is this is the map during those period. So what is the problem he faced is, being the resident of a particular city, Königsberg. So now it is called Prussia. So then that period it was called Prussia. Now it is Kaliningrad. So what he used to do is, he has to travel from one place to another place by visiting the nodes along a edge, along a path, provided that he should not visit the same path again. So that was the problem imposed on her. So he was thinking to solve the real world problem by taking the map of the particular locality. And then they compare real world situation. That is, there is a river in the Königsberg city, that is a Prigl River. And that Prigl River is flowing this, in this fashion. So it is coming here, branching out. Again, it is merging here. Again, it is branching out. It is coming like this. So there are small land portion here as well as a land portion here. So across the bridge, so across the river, bridges have been constructed. That is, it is said that 7 bridges have been set. Now the people have some idea or some wonder whether it would be possible to walk through a city by crossing each bridge exactly once and return to the original starting point. So that was the problem. That was the game, idea also. That is the challenge that everyone was facing on those days. And the challenge was given to Euler. And Euler, what he did is, being a mathematician, he knew that these kind of situation can be kind of represented using graph. Because as it going to be a geographical landscape, so those can be easily represented by a graph. So he constructed a graph for this picture, where the vertices represents the landmass, that is the portion of the land, and the edge connecting the node, that is vertex, is going to be the bridge. Now he is interested to do a solution for that graph, that is a simpler graph, which has 7 edges. And the 7 edges have been connected by vertices. So what he has to do, he has to start from one vertex, So he has to start from one vertex. Say, for example, like this, he has to start from one vertex, and he has to start here, goes here, comes here, comes here, then goes here, goes here. Then see, again, I want to coming this way. So that is not possible. So you have to go all the bridge paths. You have to visit all the edges once, but not more than once. But ultimately, he has to come to the starting position. Suppose if he starts from here. So likewise, he addressed this problem because it is a very small problem. By giving a small idea, he solved this problem in a very clever manner on those days. But later on, he thought about it. Why can't it be a very big problem? How can be the solution be? Since it is a very small graph, by means of trial and error, what is meant by trial and error? First, I will go this way. First, I will try to go this way. I will start this way. I go this way, then come out, then go this way, then go this way, then come out, then go this way, then go visit the work. Now, I end up with non-visiting one particular path. And I am again entering into this path. So my is wrong. In case if I choose this one, now I go this way, I am entering this way, I am going this way, entering this way, this way, this way. Fine, but I didn't use this path. And if I want to use this path, I have to come this along the way and then enter, and again I pass through this way. So this is also not a problem. So by means of trial and error, I can find the solution to the problem. So now it is a challenge to you. You take a picture of this bridge and you trace a path and post it to our group. If possible, now you can take a picture of this and you with the or you can draw this in your notebook. Drew a line by marking the vertex as well as the edge, and you construct a Euler circuit, and then you post your answer through WhatsApp. So it is like a game. It's like a game. So if you're interested, you can do. Let's see how many of you are finding the solution. But for this kind of situation, when the graph is very bigger, very bigger, very bigger. So what Euler thought is, we need to give a systematic way. That means we need to provide an algorithm so that any large number of graphs, any big size graph with the enormous number of vertices and edges can also be dealt easily with that kind of problem. So that's what Euler is dealing about. So when you are going to deal with the algorithm, so what the algorithm is, then a graph is given to you with n number of vertex and m number of edges that is connecting the vertex. First is your first task is you have to choose any one vertex and label that vertex as S. Now you started construct a circuit. Let us say that circuit means path. Say that circuit or path is C. And your constraint is you have to begin and end at the same S. Now, if a circuit that is going to draw, you draw, now you start from one vertex. If a circuit includes all the edges, if you find that, if the circuit that you draw includes all the edges, definitely what you have to do, you have to go to the steps 8. What is step 8? Step 8 will the one that is the last step, you have to stop the process, leaving that C as an Euler circuit for the graph. If that C doesn't include all the edges, what you have to do is, you have to choose another vertex that has an edge not in C. That means you fed up with some deadlock. You fed up in setlock. But still some more vertex have to be explored and their paths have to be explored. In that case, you leave C as one sub-circuit and start another sub-circuit C dash. Such that circuit starts and ends at a particular V. You assume you start with one V. If that circuit is named as a C dash, so that circuit C dash will start at V and is going to end at V. Remember, here also you should not use the edge that is present in C. Now, C is treated as a first sub circuit. the CDAS is considered second sub-circuit. Now what you have to do is you have to combine both the sub-circuit in order to form the final circuit, that is new circuit. Now you have to see, check, go to step 3. Why for the step 3 is there? Step 3 is whether the circuit consisting of or whether the circuit includes all the edges or not. If yes, come to the step 8, stop the process and then print the circuit. Otherwise the process is repeatedly, and repeatedly you may find any number of sub-circuits. Each sub-circuits will give you a path, and after merging all the sub-circuits to form a new circuit, and if that new circuit includes all the edges of your graph, then it means that you are going to create a perfect Euler circuit for the given graph. Let me explain this with a problem. See, this is a graph given to you. For this graph, you are asked to find the Euler circuit. Euler circuit. See the graph, how complex it is. In order to solve this problem, I need to follow the algorithm given by Euler so that my approach is very systematic manner. In that case, what I have to do as per the step, while I am going to apply the Euler algorithm, the first step of the algorithm, what it is saying, I have to choose a vertex. So it may be any vertex. So for this problem, I am choosing a B as a vertex and I label it as S. So from B, I am going to C. So here S is B because it is renamed as S. B is. So B to C, C to D, D to E, E to A, then there is no path. So I come to S. But I have many other unexplored edges. Let me explain it with the diagram here. See, I started with B, right? So I am choosing this path. Say, for example, I am choosing this path. So I have to redesignate this B as S. So what path I am choosing? I am going to B to C, C to B to C. Let me go to the next one. B to C. Next, C to D, right, then D to B, then let me see, E, then E to A, right, then from A to, I have no other way, from A to A, I have no other way to go. Maybe I can go to G, and I can go to this one, and I can go to this one. Like it, I can go randomly. But what Euler is say that is, see, when you start from B, C, D, right, and you ended with A, and finally you come to know that this path, what you have drawn here, this path won't give the perfect answer as per the constraint of the problem. So what you did is you rename this as a circuit C, and you are going to do another circuit C dash. So in order to choose another circuit as per the step 4, if you go to the step 4, choose a vertex V that is in C. C la irukkuriya or vertex you have to choose. So in that case, you need to find the edge that is not in C. That is not. So in C, if you could see, this is the circuit C. It starts from B to C, C to D, D to E, E to A, and then it comes to S. But it's not the circuit, or that is not the final circuit that lists all the edges. Since C doesn't contain all the edges, you have to go to the step 4. And in the step 4, what you have to do is you have to choose any one vertex in order to form another sub-circuit. So now with the help of D, the path is drawn like that. How it is drawn is from D, where is D? Yeah, yes, D. Where D I have taken? From the circuit C. The circuit C, I have taken D. But I should not take D to E or E to A or C to D, any path. My path, that is my edge, should be a D1. That's what the condition here. So my vertex V should be in the C, but my edge should not be in C. Should not be in C. So in that way, you have to start with the. So I have started with the D, since the D is well within the given well within the first stage of circuit that we found so far. So the D I have started from D. I should not visit E. If I visit E, then I am revisiting the already visited vertex. That is edge. So what I did is I need to took a new path. So from D I have to go to G. Then according to that G2 F, then according to this GF2 E, then then G, then G, then G2 H, then G2 H, then H2 then H, then H2 E, then H2 E, then E2 I, then I2 H, then that H2 B, then that B2 D. So I have started here and I have reached here. So how is it possible? Why are you using this side? Why can't be the other side? I already told that is a trial and error approach. So you have to choose any direction or any edge. And you have to ensure while doing that trial and error, you should not overlap the already visited edge. That's what I am comparing with the AND solution and I am giving the answer. Now, what is here is, if you could see that, what is here is, see the original circuit is having SD, this formula, so this circuit, and the that is initial circuit. The sub circuit is having this one. So what you have to do is you have to simply merge this set with this. That is, C dash should be merged with C. What you have to do is just you keep this the entire string and place it here. So yes, C is coming from this C. This two thing is coming from C. Then followed by that, this D, G and everything is coming. D, G, F, E, everything is coming, D. And then this one, E, A, S, the balance of C, So until now, what do you have done? The combined process, the merging process of C and C dash. So how the C and C dash is merged, if you could see that, let me show you again how that is merged is, T. It is placed, this particular string is placed here, So this SC is from C, this D2, this D is from C dash, and this E and AS is from C, right? So that is merged. Now you have to go to step three. So what is step three? You have to check whether all the edges as well as all the vertex have been visited or not. If yes, then you have to come out and print the string, that is the circuit as the final circuit. And this circuit is called Eulerian circuit. I hope you understand the idea for the circuit. Likewise, there are problems asked for this kind of question. A graph is given to you and you are asked to find out the Eulerian circuit. Finally, application of graphs. So we come to the end of the class. So in graph, there are still many more ideas you need to study. But all those topics are not listed in the syllabus. But I'm sure that the next semester, you will study a subject called design and analysis of algorithms. There you study a concept called more advanced usage of graphs. So what are the applications of graphs? See, graphs play a more vital role in giving out a solution for many kind of problems, even many real world problems. See, look at it. You know that Google Maps, your Google timeline also is showing you, or you can use your GPS on while you are going for travel. It will give some shortest path, or it will give some alternate path. So those kind of stuff. So there are certain problems which are not covered in their syllabus. That is the minimum spanning tree problem, and Prim's algorithm, Kruskal's algorithm, and these kind of stuff you will be studying in the next semester. So as far as this application is concerned, you can find a shortest path using by representing the any system, that is especially the transportation system, as a graph. And Google Map is one kind of application for graph theory, which uses the transportation system as a graph and uses some algorithms in order to find the shortest path, right? So those algorithms we will be dealing in the next semester. Likewise, Facebook, that is a kind of social network. So this is one is transportation network online. This is a social media, even your WhatsApp, Instagram, or some LinkedIn, ResearchGate. So anything you may take as a friend request, a friend of friend as a friend, like that, if the network is goes. So you may create this as a, what is that, network. And your PG students, and there is one more subject that is very interesting subject, that is a social network analysis. Even the people who dealing with the cybercrime is also working with these kind of stuff. Maybe in future, after your BE, if you want to have some specialized course with respect to cyber security, you can also have this kind of stuff. You should have some mathematical background about graph theory. And in operating system, you can also find an application, that is a resource allocation graph. That's what we studied in the topological ordering. In topological ordering, each node is treated as a resource. And what resource you need to execute or you need to allocate, that kind of stuff you may dealt under with the operating system. Then see, in almost all the fields you can find a graph. So when you talk about a tree or graph dominates among all the data structure, because it is very close to many real world problems. So in computer science, you can use it for communication, data communication, computer organization, that is data organization, or any computational devices. So networks. So likewise, we should send about social networks, or we can say that transportation systems with respect to any app like that. So in chemistry or physics, you may deal with some kind of molecules. Molecules, though we can represent. See, even in your plus two level, you have studied about organic and inorganic chemistry with some kind of models. So those are graphs. So graph and social science, you know that sociology, that is what is the Euler solved a problem. It is a sociology problem. So he started to solve that sociology problem. Later he find that if that situation is very large scale, how to solve the problem then only. So in mathematics, using geometry, you can find this kind of, even you in the first semester you have studied a subject, that is also little bit you find an application of graph. Even graph theory is a separate mathematics subject that has been studied widely by many people and did research in most of the topics. So that is. So biology also you can say, so you may say that the life cycle, you may say that if anyone outside agent attacks, how your biology life cycle get converted or get changed or get disturbed. So everything you can treat it as a graph. So these are the topics that I wish to discuss as per the syllabus is concerned for today's class. So as usual, you don't depend only on my lecture material. You visit many of the web resources as well as YouTube channels. I do not ask you to refer only these websites and only these YouTube channels. But my preparation to a certain extent will use these web resources as well as YouTube channels. You can also use that if you want, or you can find any other better web YouTube channel or better web resources for your case. That's what I have given you, a 3-minute presentation. So I asked you to go for some outside material on your own. So you explore many websites. You may explore many YouTube channels. You find some better YouTube channels. You can subscribe to the channels and you can start listening to the lectures. Not only for the subject of this unit, but for any other knowledge enhancement and enrichment, you can always use that. So with this, I close this session. So here I will put one text box, which includes the URL for all the YouTube links of this particular video, not this particular unit. So already I uploaded the two YouTube URLs, and I have uploaded the YouTube URLs into the Google Classroom. So here also I will upload the same into the Google Classroom, and here also I display the one. I think with this, I will close the topic. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Otherwise, we can wind up.